Hello, and welcome to another episode of Minecraft with Painful Fodder and Mindless Machines, who is not currently here yet, but should be here any time. figured I'd start with the view from up here. As you can see, we got a nice thick wall going around. That's our storage system. Goes all the way around the castle. That's our grounds. Outside, we have this little thing here that we might do some work on today, put in some supports. We have down there a villager with some doors. And in here, we have two villagers here, which is kind of a pain, but we do... We were able to breed these two, and then their children fall into there. They were getting stuck on a block, so I put a water source to push the children off into this water source. This is just what happened since last week, and they basically follow this water source all the way down here, turn the corner, come all the way over here. And then they come all the way over here. And they end up right here. And then what I do is I come in this door. I break this glass here. And that glass there. I put a minecart here. Push it in there. It doesn't pick anything up. I put another minecart. Oh, I also put a powered rail there, and a powered rail there. Hello, Mr. Mindless.
Hello, hello.
I'm explaining how I get the villagers out of this thing.
So,
you're in the middle of that conversation.
Okay.
So the first cart goes in, doesn't pick anybody up. The second cart goes in, bounces back out this way. But the first one does pick up a villager, then it bounces back out this way. I'm not sure why it doesn't go this way, but some just in case. Either way, comes down here, stops here, where I can push him along. And then they go into here. And from there, I hit this button. And that turns on water. And... the reason it's pushing me is because I didn't replace that glass. I had to manually get in there to fix an issue we were having, and then it pushes them along to the next open spot. So that's how that works. Did you get all that, Mr. Mindless?
Sure.
Okay. There will be a quiz later. But we do have some villagers to trade with. They are crappy. But anyway, there is some shops open. It is a pain getting these suckers to breed, I'll tell you that. I'm constantly having to trade with them to make them happy, and then I'll walk away and I'll come back and there'll be a kid sometimes, but not a lot.
I'm just not really consistent then, huh?
Yeah, I don't know. They must not be teenagers. I don't know what the deal is, but they're definitely not into it. But anyway, the storage system is done. We have six spots over here that I don't have assigned yet. Other than that, they're all assigned.
Wow.
I changed a few things, if you would like a tour, except for what I just showed them, the little breeding thing. We have now a little opening here.
I see this.
I like it. This kind of looked a little nicer. And then we also have one up here, which will take you up to this tower, which has a ladder, which is how you can get up to the breeding station.
Yeah, I checked that out when I hopped in.
So, Then if you kind of walk along here, I'm going to have to see why those two are on, probably because it's over that, blocking the sun. And then we walk around here, we got a nice little opening. And then we come along here and we look at the chests are gone now. That's feeding directly into the system now. So iron and poppies are getting sorted.
Crazy.
And then we come over here and we got this tree. Well, what? There's this thing here. What's that for? Let's find out. Let's go in now. Got a little couch.
Nice.
So then we come over and we keep walking. Keep walking, keep walking. This way. Tour moves this way. And to your right, you will see some more skeleton horses. And a cow. Oh, what's this? This is where you make your, secret deals.
Oh, yeah.
Little place for that. And then we come over here. Looks like I missed the block. I'm going to put that one in. And then, of course, you just wanted to have private boxes. So everybody can have their own. There's not much of a view here, but, you're tired.
Sure.
And then you come over here. I put a nice little pattern. I've got some skeleton horses. I haven't quite figured out how to get out of there. And then you can come down here, and you're back into the system. That chest will lead into the storage system.
Nice.
There's some... So if you're looking for quartz or nether stuff, this is your area. And then we got some fish and food. And there's your food. And then we got, what's over here? Plant stuff. But first, let's look at this tree. Let's go up the tree. Oh, what's this? Oh, there's something up here. Another seating area.
Nice choice of wood.
Yeah, I figured it matched the tree.
Looks really nice. Actually, the view up here is pretty nice.
Yeah, I thought so. I thought it'd be another place, get another look at things. And if we expand out any direction over here, this would be a good viewing area for it. So, and you already had the vines growing, so,
Right. Well, I wanted to have a big jungle tree somewhere within the lot here. In fact, one of the things that I've been kind of considering for the last several weeks is where to put a proper orchard in and how I'd want to lay that all out. So, but this was just a start to get a jungle tree in.
No. And I made use of it.
I'm a big fan of the giant oaks and the jungle trees just because of how big they are.
We seem to be breeding these horses. I don't know how, but every time I get on, it seems like there's another one.
Well, last time I was on, I got attacked by another set of four horsemen and captured all four of the horses, so it might be some of them.
Ah, maybe that's it. And then more plant stuff. And more plant stuff. Trees. Then your glasses and sand. What's in here? I don't know what that's supposed to be. Probably sand. No. I don't know. I got a missing one there.
Interesting.
This is your fences and fence gates of the different woods.
Wow.
And then you got your slabs, your stairs, your blocks, and then your raw wood. And of course your trading. We do have trades now.
Awesome.
And then down here is your charcoal, coal, lapis, fermented spider eye. You know, your more precious things. Of course, your most precious here because these are a pain in the butt.
Yes, they are.
So, to get that one, that was a pain in the eye. But I had to make this look a little nicer since it is your precious element. So, and basically, if you want to kill the breeder,
you just drop the key.
So you don't really want to break these torches. Usually I just put a switch and then flip the switch, which turns off the torch, and then wait for the thing to die on these things, and then I put it, take the switch away. But basically, what we have now, there's some okay we'll keep, but they seem expensive. So, anywho,
cool.
That is the storage system. Now I just got to get everything in our storage system into the works so it gets sorted.
I guess we need to rebuild the cemetery elsewhere as well.
Either that or at least move, like, this stone here or something. Maybe make it one wider and move everything on this side one this way. I'm lagging a little bit. Wonder why. Probably all the poppers.
Yeah, I guess I'm a little lower than normal, but I'm...
Of course, it doesn't help that it's raining.
Yeah, that's nice. We could always crash.
Yeah.
If today might help get rid of the weather. Or you can command it away if you wanted to do that.
I gotta sleep. I'm tired. It's been a long day. But yeah, very laggy. Settings down a little bit. Let's see. Scale, bright, charcoal. We'll do that. That should help. Okay. Oh, why did I go out here? I don't know. Still a little laggy. Not bad, though.
I got a little lag, too, but I think it's just loading lag for me.
Yeah, I think it'll catch back up eventually. I mean, there's a lot of hoppers now. Like I said, I dream of placing hoppers. There they are. Okay, now we'll come back over here. Thank you. So, what I can do. This all set up. Make another chest because I'm getting too many items. I filled up a chest and it's still feeding into the system, so I put another chest on top of it so that I can put more items.
You can dump two chestfuls of items at a time, huh?
Yep.
You wouldn't think you'd need it till you need it.
I definitely need it. I'm not even halfway. I'm just doing the bottom row, and I've already filled up a double chest. I don't think I'm sorting nuggets. I'll turn this into a gold ingot, because I am sorting those. No, I'm not sorting this. The bottom row done. Now I get to do the rest the easy way, which is hopper it all together and let them take care of themselves. At least on this side. So I got to do. Gotta get up there. Let's see. Top ones that go into that one, which will feed into this line, which goes straight into that chest, which feeds into that chest. So you should be seeing these out and out. Yep, see, there's that. Moving into here, which is then feeding into the hopper chain. Yay! Working on the wooden items. And now the food. Okay, now to get these into there. Hey, mindless.
Yeah.
Know what I'm doing? Huh? You know what I'm doing?
Decorating?
I'm placing hoppers.
I'm shocked.
That's what I've been doing for days. Just days. Hoppers and hoppers and hoppers. So I thought it'd be Interesting, just to let you know that I'm placing hoppers.
I feel like that probably would have been my safest answer, but...
I thought you would have said it, but it's early in the night, you know.
I was going for reverse psychology. I think you were saying that to imply that you were doing something I wouldn't suspect.
Oh, well, that's just silly talk.
I played the wrong card, I guess.
Yeah. Okay. There's that. Nothing in that one. Nothing in that one. Something in that one. This has got crap in it too. Just so you know, with all those chests and everything, I do not have any wool sorted.
Okay.
So, even with that massive size, we still have things that won't be sorted.
I see.
Which kind of blows my mind, because I thought there would be plenty of room. But we do got six things that can be sorted, so.
Well, I just learned it's apparently entirely possible to shoot yourself with your own arrow while running.
Yes, that's how you fly indefinitely, definitely with the elytra. You get a punch two bow, good armor, mending, so that you can mend yourself, because it's going to ruin your armor. And an infinity on your bow so that you don't run out of arrows. And you jump off and you shoot yourself as you're flying, and it'll just keep punching you up. You're making a lot of noise over there.
Oh, yeah, I'm actually playing in the kitchen tonight as Carrie's making dinner.
Sorry.
You might be hearing her in the background as she's preparing.
Well, that's okay, just making sure everything's all right, you know. Out of this system and into the other one. So I'm not sure what we're doing with this room, but it should be empty at a few minutes. Might have to move my trash.
Now that's easy enough.
Yeah, just need a bucket and pick up the lava and all the redstone. And... that one. I just put my pick in there. No. That would have sucked. Do we want to make that bigger? See what we got down here. So, probably items is going there. That's fine. Finish items go there. We do have finish items. Fuel goes into there. Probably should leave that there. But I kind of want. Okay, everybody's probably wondering what I'm saying. I'm talking to myself, as usual. What I am trying to do is figure out, well, for one, I have to redo this farm because it doesn't auto-harvest diddly squat. And I have to do something here because this doesn't auto-harvest because it's not even set up to. And the tree farm with the birch doesn't seem to work with the diddly squat. So it's basically an oak farm. And we do get slimes. I'm almost filled up the chest, but there's no way for these guys to go up. So I have to build an item elevator that I will put from the bottom one all the way up. And I think the perfect spot for that would be probably this corner here. And there's lava down there. Awesome. It's okay, we'll make it work. I have to cover up the lava. let's do this. Bring up my notes. Come on. Open up. Okay. Item. Elevator. And I'm going to get the coordinates. Basically right here. Now comes the fun part. Does that interfere with anything? So that should be okay. How are we doing on sugar cane? Completely full and backed up. Okay. So yes, it has been a while since I've checked on the farms. So yeah. This way. That should probably free it up. At least until I get it going automatically sorted. But that could be a problem. I have to turn that off. Okay. figure out how much glass I have.
Do we need more sand then?
We're going to, because I'll definitely use all the glass I have, but I'm pretty sure I'll need more because you have 9 per layer. And it's going to go from the bottom to the top. And somehow I got to get some of the other things that aren't at the bottom to the bottom. Or have 2 item elevators. I haven't figured out what I'm doing yet. But yeah, we'll definitely want more sand, but I want to build a portal at the desert anyway, so. Definitely not a wasted trip. So, let's get to those coordinates and dig down. So we are minus 51. So right here, 374. So we gotta go this way. Convenient. I think that goes to the storage system. Awesome. That works. Okay, my luck does not get that good.
You sure it's not the trash line?
Yeah, because the trash line is just goes into a cubby. This will work just fine. 1, 2, let's see, probably 1 more, right? 374 to 376. Okay, we'll be okay with that. Hopper line, we'll leave that, so it's this one. That. We'll go ahead and do that. All right. Get rid of that so I can see. And for those viewing, the reason I'm excited is because this is the line that goes, well, one of the many lines that goes to the storage system, the beginning of it anyway. And this little 3x3 area is the top of my elevator farm, so all I have to do is put hoppers going into that line, and once the elevator brings items up, goes in the hoppers, straight into the line, piece of cake. Nothing works that easy for me. Nothing. Except for this time. So now all I gotta do is dig all this out, and we are good to go. Of course, now that that was so easy, there'd probably be an Ender Dragon down here.
Mysterious Wither pops up.
Yeah, he's probably having tea with the Wither boss, and being served by a bunch of Endermen.
Yeah, I do wonder how the difficulty is adjusted on the game. When we started, we were at 3.75, and it's now lowered.
Well, I'm in a hole, so that probably helps. You don't want to attack a guy in a hole. I mean, that's just mean, right?
Well, sure, but that's ultimately trench warfare that you're describing.
It is, but I have the trench. So, you know, they know better than to attack me. Of course, I am doing it mostly in the dark, so. I am asking for it.
I mean, it has been a long time since we've added a grave.
Uh-huh. Because I've been inside the walls. Once I have to go get sand, it'll change. Okay, what do we got here? Did I already dig that out? I'm sure this is riveting for everybody watching. I'm riveted, just riveted.
I would describe my emotion as of like a rivet quality.
Oh, well, see? I knew this would be riveting. I mean, digging a hole straight down is always exciting. I don't care who you are. I mean, people would pay money to watch that. and only got 30 more levels to go.
I usually am excited to watch people dig holes straight down because it's always comical when lava appears.
I am doing it a little safer, and I also went down to the lowest level and found out that I can't go quite beyond 10 or I will hit lava. So I did do a little research.
I usually stop between 10 and 13 if I'm going, you know, to essentially the basement.
Well, I would like to have that, but we did build the slime farms, so I have to go at least that far to get all the slime up. Otherwise, I got to build an item elevator to get them up to the item elevator, and that just seems silly. Another cavern that I've explored. Wall that off so I'm back in the dark. I would hate to do this safely in the light. More light, another cavern. Yay. Caverns are always lovely because you never know what you're going to get. They're like a box of chocolates.
Mm-hmm.
They say life is like a box of chocolates, but I think caverns are like a box of chocolates. You just don't know what you're going to get.
Sort of fun sniping enemies from the front walkway there at night, and then when day rolls around, you run around and they'll... ground is just littered with experience points.
Yeah. Well, you know, if they'd just stay away, they could live.
It's true.
Not like we were having a party and sending out invites.
I mean, if you see a guy standing there in fully enchanted diamond armor with an enchanted flaming bow firing arrows your direction, if I was a mob, I'd probably just take that opportunity to bail.
Yeah. Especially if I'm just going to stand there and watch him do it.
They're certainly not putting the eye in artificial intelligence now, are they?
Nope. But there's no eye in team. There isn't me, though.
Well, there's an eye in team. You just have to find it in the negative space of the A.
Okay, that's deep. I just wish I would have known that there's a me, and I would have thought of that as a kid. All the coaches, there's no I in team. Yeah, but there's a me.
I seem to do a profoundly good job at annoying coaches, not even trying to be quick-witted. It just seemed to be my natural quality was annoying to coaches.
So that's your superpower.
I guess.
The coach annoyer strikes again.
See me coming and they go, oh, that guy.
He's on your team. I don't want him. Is this the bottom level? Please, is it the bottom? I think this is. Yep, that's it. I have dug down to level 10. And all I have to do is get down, looks like two more levels, which means I have to do something with lava.
You got a bucket? Got some water?
I don't really want to do that because I got to get rid of the lava. Not so much. That's going to be a problem. can't reach the bottom. The freaking lake here.
So, gravel?
Yeah, how much of that do I got? None.
I'm curious how the sorting system would handle armor.
It's going to go to the miscellaneous chests.
Yeah, I guess to clarify, what I'm curious about is, are you able to put only a single piece of armor into a chest, a single piece of a single type of armor into a chest?
Yes.
And have it for that? So you can't just say all gold armor, and then, yeah, that's kind of what I thought, because the comparator just looks at the very specific item that's in the chest next to it, right?
Basically, the comparator has, or a hopper has 5 slots. Okay.
Right.
And so you have 4 slots, which I've used dirt that I've renamed to be do not use. Because if you put in dirt that has been renamed to do not use, it will break the sorting system. But since dirt doesn't come named do not use, it's a great item to use. And then in the last slot, the one on the left, you put the item you want to sort. Now, let's say you want iron ingots. So you want to put at least 18 iron ingots in that left-hand side. In fact, where are you at?
I'm actually out front terraforming.
Okay. Because I think a visual tutorial would work best here.
Ah.
But I got to figure out how to get to it without breaking anything. It might be good to go over it again. Yeah, this will work. So, I have some cobble. We'll put cobble there. Cobble there. There's a sorting system, so that should work. Okay. So, we'll do cobble there. And then all I have to do is bust that out. And dig myself back out of this mess.
I'm doing the economy style terraforming, as you can see.
Yeah. I was like, boy, we have a lot of floating land on this.
Yeah, well, it takes so much effort to... It takes so much effort and resources to do a proper terraform without doing something like MC Edit or something like that.
Well, I'm fine with it. If I ever want to do anything weird underneath, I have room.
Yeah, I figure it's wiring space.
Which I definitely filled up the middle.
Yeah, I think I'm going to expand this out for a decent way. And I think what the front is going to end up being is more of like a proper orchard.
You want the visual real quick?
Sure.
Okay. So I busted through the wall here. So the mechanics of it is, if you look in this chest right here, the one next to the comparator, you'll see the block or dirt blocks and then the pressure plates.
Okay.
The reason the pressure plates aren't moving at all is because this comparator is saying there's something in this hopper, and there is a redstone coming out of the comparator, and another redstone that goes down a block. So there's two redstone lines, which 18 items of 64 stackable and the four pieces of dirt will power one line of redstone, but won't power the second one. Okay.
Interesting.
Now, because of that, I'm going to fall down. And then I'm going to pile up. And I'm going to, inside of here, under that block here, you will see a repeater. Okay?
Okay.
That repeater is off because the line on top of the redstone lamp is not lit. Okay?
Okay.
Which means this torch here is on, which is keeping this hopper from doing anything. It puts it in an inactive state. Nothing can go out of it. Things can still go into it, but not out of it. Okay?
All right.
So, the items come along this top line, and this hopper will say, well, can I accept the item? And the only thing it can accept is, of course, the dirt that has been renamed, do not use, and a stone pressure plate. Since there's no other room for anything else, that's the only thing it can accept. So if a stone pressure plate comes along, it's going to go into that hopper, which will power this repeater, because now it has 19 items, not 18, which is enough to turn on the redstone, which turns on the repeater, which turns off this torch, which means the 19th item can come out of here, and that's why it has to be on the left, because that's the first one that will come out. And it will go into this bottom hopper, into the chest, and then flow through. Now there's 18 items in there, which will not power this repeater, which turns on the torch, which locks it again. That's how the sorting system works.
That's really interesting and more complicated than you'd think it would be.
Yeah. Now, what gets interesting, this will work great. You can put these exactly side by side if you want, but it will only work if you're sorting 64 stackable items. So if you put an Ender Pearl in here, it will break the one next to it if they're exactly side by side. So that's why I always leave a gap, because then I can put whatever I want, and it won't bleed into the next one.
I gotcha.
So that's how a sorting system works. Not too bad.
Very cool. Mm-hmm.
So now you can do your terraforming or whatever. By the way, there is grass blocks somewhere.
Yeah, I see it. Yeah, they're in the dirt box over here.
Okay.
I'm quite rapidly clearing out all of our dirt.
Okay, looks like we're sorting some feathers.
Feathers are coming in, I guess.
Yeah, must have killed some chickens. You might check. I'll check for you, since I'm over here. Let's see. Yeah, here's another dirt in the bottom one left. So, I thought there might be more in there, but obviously not. Well, I'm going to go get rid of a bunch of glass. Did I come up here for... Oh, yeah, I did. I came up here for... I actually have buckets sorted somewhere. Where did I put the buckets? There's a skeleton. Hi, Skelly. Buckets, buckets, buckets. Where did I put the bucket? Uh-oh. Oh, there's Kelly. Ha ha. did you? Probably there.
This feels so unrewarding when you fire an arrow at a mob and they despawn just before the arrow hits them.
Well, they saw the arrow coming, and they said, hey, I cannot beat that. So they just left. They left it.
So you win. I'm out. Mm-hmm. They rage quitted.
Where did I put the buckets? I know they're sorting. Oh, they're there. Found the buckets! Take two buckets. Why do we have so many mobs in here?
Well, I've been trying to keep them out, but it was a zombie night, so tons of mobs. Hey, now.
Keep some of that with me. Keep that with me. I need to drop that off. To the furnace. Laggy, laggy, laggy. Okay. Item to smelt. Need that. Okay.
I think we need to get you a gaming rig.
I think so, yes. But, yeah.
If it makes you feel any better, my tower was built in 2003.
Well, it's probably better than my little laptop that isn't really made for gaming. But yeah.
Yeah, it's old. It's amazing it still runs.
Yeah, I want to get a gaming system. It's just, you know, if you're going to do it, you might as well get one that's going to last you for, 10 years or so. Or more. So,
yeah.
I wish I could put a hopper on lava and just have it go away.
Kind of a neat idea.
I don't want to lose one of those, so I think we'll do this. I'm trying an experiment. Yep, it works. Good. I'm picking up lava and putting it on a single lava block, and that way I can use one bucket.
Oh, yeah, I see what you're saying.
You stupid thing. Hopefully I don't die. I ate, so I think I'm maintaining. I'm still on fire, but I think I'm maintaining.
Where's your potion of fire resistance?
Well, that's upstairs. I'm way at the bottom. But if I eat, I'm... Okay. Whew. Yay! I didn't die.
Good job.
It was a close call, though. I'm gonna do the gravel trick and have a potion of fire resistance that we have a million of.
Yeah, and I mean, we can always make more, too.
Yeah. Now, if only we had a brewing system.
Some sort of revolutionary sequential brewing system would be really handy, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would. I wish I knew where one of those was at. Of course, I might be sorting all of my... Oh, no, they're in this chest over here.
I mean, it is a big mansion we built.
Yeah.
But if you, you might be able to find something like that.
Potion of fire resistance. Wow, what do you know? I didn't know we had these.
Hey, you are a winner.
Give that man a potion. gravel. Where did I put the gravel?
I want to think it's over by the, where the entrance to the horse pen is. Stable.
Over there. Could be wrong.
I could be wrong, but I thought I recalled it over there.
Yep, that's where it is.
It's amazing. Our storage system, or I should say your storage system, is so incredibly large, it's easy to forget where things are in it.
Yeah, I did try to make some sense out of it.
Oh, yeah.
But
yeah, that's...
trying to remember where I put it, you know? So, but I'm happy with it. It sorts most things, and it's got enough overflow that it shouldn't be a problem. Okay, so now back into the deep. Into the breach we go. Out the hole, but right now I know it's filled with a bunch of lava. Go ahead and do this. Thank you. mean dinner's ready?
That is the sound of dinner being consumed as it happens.
Won't my plate get cold?
Well, it is a long drive from where you're at to where I'm at, I believe. I think we're on opposite ends of town, if I recall correctly.
I don't think we're on opposite ends. We're both south, I think.
Yeah.
But we're not exactly next door neighbors, no.
Yeah, I'm southwest Lincoln.
I'm kind of central south-ish. A little bit south, though.
But, I mean, it's not like even opposite ends of Lincoln is all that particularly far apart, either.
True. Right now, the viewers get to see me getting... what am I getting? Gravel. I need a lot of gravel. Apparently.
Yeah, I'm going to need a considerable amount of dirt than what I currently have. I'm not even going to get close. I'm kind of framing out the area I want to flatten out, and once you see it, you're going to think, wow, that's ambitious.
Well, do you have a mountain you don't want?
Times like this, I love commands, but if we're doing this for sake of show, then maybe commands is the way to go.
Well... otherwise, I'd have a bunch of gravel right now, and I wouldn't be trying to dig it all up.
It's true.
Did I get my... there we go. That's probably all of it.
Hey, I made an accidental mob spawner. How about that?
Cool.
It's just a wee bit dark under that big overhang we made.
Well, you know, there is a, you capture a mob and then put a piston under him, and he's your turret.
Oh, yeah.
I thought, well, that's fine, but, you know, now you got this mob that could turn on you at any moment.
Yeah, I've never been one for the whole using a mob for defense kind of a thing.
Yeah. It seems like that's what you're trying to defend against. So.
Yeah, I mean, there's a bit of humor in using the enemy against themselves, but I just don't feel too confident about it, comfortable with it.
Okay, so with that done, I just need that, this, that. Dare come onto my gravel or I am in trouble. Okay. Now I can just gravel this out and that should be all I need. You know that I had a stack and 22 of gravel. I filled in all the lava. I have one gravel block.
Wow. And that's quite a bit.
Actually, that's not counting the first 22 that I put in.
Well, if you're looking for gravel or lava, you found another load there, I guess.
Yeah. It's all filled in now, but...
Mining for dirt is very not thrilling.
Not really, no. Maybe I can get a cobble now. Yep, okay. Awesome. Take care of everything. Yep. Okay. So, hopefully... Well, that didn't sound good.
Well, it didn't really seem to do much, but, you know. I wasn't anywhere near anything we built, so in reality, it was the least destructive it could have been, but it never feels good when a creeper gets an explosion off on you.
Yeah, if I could just make a suggestion, don't stand next to the storage system if you've got a creeper on you. I don't want to fix that.
That would be catastrophic, huh?
Yeah, I think I might... You'll see a grown man cry, I think. I do believe. Bust through here. Yep. Thank you. So, as you can see, glass does not go that far. So, off to the desert. But first, let me check all this. See if all this has made it. It has not. Chests over here are empty. That's good. So that one is done. That one's done. That one's done. That one's done. That one's done. Okay, one side is done. Other side is not. Okay, I want to get, I do have, it's good. We're at it. Get rid of that. That needs to go to the furnace. Anything else? Eh. We'll forget the hoppers for now. Torches. Keep. Don't need that, but we will keep it. Please don't help me. Okay, and built items would already be out here. Thank you. I'm looking for what?
Sorry, I'm fresh out of what?
I just had some, and I put in the sorting system. Of course, that's going to take a while to get through, so... I don't know if I have a chest for flint, though.
There is a sort of funny little Easter egg in the Starbound game, where if you try to use a command to spawn something, but you don't properly format your string, it pops out what's a green block called a perfectly generic item. And oddly enough, you can actually build perfectly generic armor and perfectly generic weapons from those blocks.
They any good, or?
You know, they're okay. They're definitely not endgame stuff. It's just sort of a funny little Easter egg where it's like, how did I end up with this perfectly generic item? And you look at your string and you're like, oh, it's an incomplete string. But then you realize you can craft with it and you think, huh. So then you just give yourself a bunch of perfectly generic items by misformatting spawn item commands. And then you start playing around with it. And that in itself is sort of fun. Not that I'm command cheating my way through the game. I like playing with games, command line prompts and stuff like that once I've beaten it. You know, see what else I can do with it.
Yeah. I wasn't going to say anything.
You were thinking it. I could feel it.
Okay, I got that, and I am ready to go. I am going to put the flint into the system. Why not? Got nothing better to do. I'm going to go get a horse. And I'm going to go to the desert and build a portal.
Does your horse have no name?
Currently, it does not.
So you're riding through the desert on a horse with no name?
Riding to the desert with a horse with no name.
Oh. When you get there, you have to let me know if it's felt good to get out of the rain.
Okay. Well, right now it's not raining, so.
That song's gonna be stuck in my head all night now.
Not my fault.
No, I have only myself to blame for that.
I mean, usually it's something I might do, but this time it was all you.
Yeah, that was me. But hey, I thought the joke was well executed and very much worth it to get a song stuck in my head.
Oh, yeah. And it's a good song, you know.
Fantastic song.
Better songs, but it's a good song, too.
Well, you know, songs, you know, the quality therein is sort of in the eye of the beholder as well, you know. Oh.
Some people say, man, that's the best song ever, man. How could you say that? And it's like, well, because I like songs that wake me up, because that's usually when I'm listening to music, is when I'm tired and I need to wake up. And there's not really one that'll do it. You'll sing to it, though.
I guess, I primarily listen for novelty and production technique. But I listen to a lot of electronic music, so, you know, when someone does something new and interesting, that to me isn't, you know, appealing. But whenever someone says this is the best song ever, I say, what's the next best song? Mm-hmm. Not as easy to answer that question.
Well, it also changes. Did I go the wrong way? There's no way I went the wrong way. I went the wrong way?
Sounds like you went the wrong way.
Somehow I turned around. Because that's where I came from.
So you went the wrong way on a horse with no name.
Yep. Went the wrong way on a horse with no name. Had to turn around and go the other way. Something like that.
Yeah, that works.
Yeah, I'll go with it.
I'd give you an A for effort.
I don't want to know about execution. I'll stick with effort.
I'm not sure if your interval was exactly correct either. I think you were doing fifth down.
Yeah, well, I think that's good. I didn't really want to put forth the energy to, you know, go full bore. So.
Well, you know how it is. Whenever you're singing a melody without the accompanying chord, sometimes it sounds a little awkward. Because,
especially if you're trying to make it up on the spot.
Right. So, you know, credit given where credit due. It was certainly more effort than I was willing to put forth.
Well, fine then. If that's the way you want to do it.
It would have been funnier as if I would have been singing the harmony, just, you know, improvised on top of that.
Yeah.
But I'm guessing with lag that we'd have some sort of, like, inherent complications that we'd discover that apparently singing vocal harmony, you know, a la barbershop style, probably isn't best to be done over Discord.
I think probably it's better than what, you know, we were using. Because
sure.
I think we're pretty much right on. And I think that's why everybody's switching to Discord. You know, the other versions, you know, there's a lag or it's crappy quality, and Discord just makes everything easy about it.
Well, it's nice, too, that it's just, it's resource light.
Yeah.
But I can see why people like it. You know, I've certainly had this conversation with other friends with, you know, where they were looking to set up some sort of a TeamSpeak. It's like, no, Discord.
Yeah. Well, people, the Twitch streamers, the big ones, used to use TeamSpeak, and now they're going to Discord.
Well, I don't know if TeamSpeak has improved, but the last several times I've used TeamSpeak, it was just incredibly prone to being hacked. And maybe it was just that the hacker groups were, you know, had matured in their technique of hacking TeamSpeak. But man, I tell you, every TeamSpeak server I think I've ever used, you know, I've never purchased one myself, but I've used a lot of friends' TeamSpeak, and I'm pretty sure almost all of them have been hacked at one point or another.
That's not good.
Well, usually just defaced, you know, which is, you know, as far as hacking goes, like, whatever. It's like, haha, we did it because we could, kind of a thing. And it's like, you know, bravo.
Yeah. So how did that help you in any way?
Right. But hey, you know, I'm not going to discount the fact that there's certainly entertainment value in learning how to break things. I mean, that's ultimately, you know, how you build a programmer.
Yeah.
Or rather, a debugger, I guess.
Well, when I was in high school, I was pretty much in every computer class. And so they had an honors computer class with three people picked, and I was one of those. And the first lesson was, okay, it was basically on the Atari. Or not Atari, Apple, like 2E.
Oh, the Apple II?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they used to have those discs, and you would have games on there, and it says, okay, break into it. And it's like, you want us to what? Yeah, I want you to, you know, decode it, and I want you to be able to play this game without having the key. Okay. So that was lesson one.
Ethical, quote-unquote, hacking.
Yeah. Well, I guess they figured if you know how to do it, then, you know, we'll help you stop it, I guess.
Well, I suppose the ulterior motive was there was some teacher was like, hey, I got this copy of the game, but I've only got one copy and I want to share it with my friends. I'll just get the students to figure out how to crack it.
Yeah, that'll work.
To this day, I still have not admitted to any of my teachers that I knew how to get into the Commodore system that they used for grade keeping.
You didn't tell them because you didn't know?
No. I certainly knew how to get into the system. I just didn't want them to know that I knew how to do it, because then, you know, all those grades I entered would have been obviously fake instead of not obviously fake.
In other words, I was giving you an out and you did not take it.
Nah. I'm not so worried about incriminating myself on this server. Chances that any of my previous teachers are watching this video or these videos that we're making are pretty much slim to none.
Okay.
I take it now now it's more of a bragging right. Like, you know, they're like, do your homework. And I'm like, yeah, okay. And then, you know, my homework was essentially, how can I make this system work better for me and gain something I actually want? And that was computer skills. Is it any wonder that to this day, the three primary jobs that I do, they're all done on a computer?
Yes, completely.
Yeah, shocker, right?
Yeah, it's, I mean, I would be surprised. I don't know, I've always been with computers, and so. That's
nice. Yeah, computers are my friends.
Yeah.
I still wish I had one of those old Commodores, you know, the big floppy disks that you had to put in to boot them up.
Yeah.
Once they booted, you pulled the disk out, and you had to put whatever program you wanted to run in, and you had to command line it to get it to run.
Yeah, I remember those. My first computer was the Atari, saved them on cassette tapes.
Mm-hmm.
That was interesting. Now I just want things to work fast.
I'm actually playing on an MSI G series laptop, which I gotta say, for a gaming laptop, they're brilliant. They're a little bit on the pricey side, but MSI is one of those companies I've been with for over 10 years as far as computer parts. And I think they're a little bit more well known now, but they're a Taiwanese company, and man, I gotta tell you, I'm really impressed with what they've built here. But it's, you know, the price range is exactly what you would expect for a gaming rig. You know, you're not going to buy a gaming rig for under $1,000. That's going to really be what you want.
Yeah.
Which is unfortunate because that's, you know.
For people not exactly like me, you know, I don't really have that kind of cash right now. So I'm stuck on a laptop. And not a gaming laptop, just a plain old laptop.
Well, to put it into perspective, it was about maybe 12 years in between when I could afford a new computer. I used to work with a guy who said that he couldn't stand having a computer that was more than 2 years old, and I just couldn't wrap my head around that. But how, you know, it's like basically he spends all of his money on computers all the time.
Yeah.
Which, you know, he was an IT guy, so I guess it kind of makes sense, but I remember when Battlefield 2 came out, he says, I can render shadows on my character's hands. And it was, I'm not going to lie, it was when they first introduced ATI Crossfire technology where you could run two graphics cards side by side.
Mm-hmm.
Man, those were the days. Of course, now that's pretty, I don't know, it just seems silly now. You can just buy a video card that's essentially a second computer and slap that inside your computer.
Yeah, in fact, Intel, at the last PAX, they built a computer that's really two computers, an i7 and an i3, running in the same box.
Weird. What purpose?
Well, what you would have is you'd have your i3 doing your streaming and stuff, your i7 playing the game.
Ah.
And they're built so that they can talk to each other very fast.
That's awesome.
So
they have their own bus or something? That's weird.
Yeah. So it's two computers, you know. And that's kind of the setup a lot of people are using now, is they have one box to stream and one box to play the game. And some of them even have a third just to do, you know, web searches or have a chat window or something. But most of them will do that on the streaming box because, let's face it, it's not doing too terribly much. I think there's an Enderman convention over here.
The moms are definitely stepping it up out front, I can say that.
Well, they are here, too. I mean, it's nighttime, and I didn't bring a bed, so I killed a bunch, and they just keep spawning.
Have you made it to the desert then, I assume?
Yep. And it's not raining. So that's good.
You're living the dream.
Yeah. I'm in the desert with a horse with no name.
Skeleton horse with no name.
I'm going to build a portal. I'm trying to figure out where I want to do that. But I want to make sure I don't look at any Endermen. I wonder if there's any villagers still in this village.
They probably all got converted to zombies by now.
This is a pyramid, I think. Yeah, it's a pyramid. Hey! Leave me alone. I gotta eat. They are really mean. Don't they know I'm trying to eat some dinner?
Maybe they know how you obtained that chicken. And they're PETA activists.
Well, there's probably that too.
So how dare you cook chicken with lava?
I don't know where they all came from. I mean, this was empty a minute ago. Creepers, skeletons, husks, or whatever the heck those new things are.
Yeah. Is it husks are the one in the deserts, and strays are the one in the icy ones, in the icy biomes?
Yeah, I think so. If I had to guess, I would say that's right.
I think that's how that works. Oh, excuse me.
Where you think you're going, buddy? I saw you. Hey! Who did that? Oh, where'd you come from? What's the deal? Going in here where there's some light. Jeez. Leave me alone, people. What do you think this is? He's trying to get some sand. Is it daytime yet?
Almost.
Because these suckers need to burn.
I don't think the husks will, though.
They won't, but I can kill them. I'm underground right now. It's safer.
Alright, we are officially at sunrise.
Yay. Okay, guys. You're gonna be burning. I'm coming out.
Okay, they should start lighting on fire right about now.
Yeah, just gotta get rid of creepers. Stuff I don't really need. That's right, Punky. Okay, so let's see how long we died. Down that. Okay, let's just get some sand. Thank you. If I take all the sand from a desert, what does it become?
A landscape of sandstone block. My best guess.
This is very satisfying.
Something about... Are you using an efficiency
shovel?
Oh yeah, that's the best. Efficiency shovel with gravel or sand is just one of the best joys in this game. It's kind of like mining netherrack with an efficiency pickaxe.
Uh-huh. Let's see where we're at. A ghost box somewhere. Dug out underneath our little passageway. I should probably put in a floor.
Guess you'll have to now.
Pretty soon you're gonna have a long drop when you get out. Okay, I was going to put in a portal. Let's get rid of the torch.
I have such a massive area I'm filling in with dirt right now. I'm just telling you right now, it's going to be a while. All because I want an orchard.
Well, you don't need dirt everywhere to do an orchard. 3x3?
No, I guess I just like planting on a very flat plane.
Yeah. I'm just saying, you could have, like, 3x3 dirts. And then the rest could be, like, a stone or something. But hey, whatever works.
Well, that's a possibility, too, but considering I'm building just outside the front of the castle, it just sort of makes sense to have it be a big yard. And perfectly, to be perfectly honest, I would love to have the whole place be a big flat plateau, and then I can kind of build my orchard around on top of that. I mean, you saw how I did it on the other map where I kind of built it on top of the ground to kind of give it a sort of nice dimensional look to it.
Yeah.
And I'm kind of thinking something similar to that, maybe a slightly different design, but, you know, kind of along those lines. Although, my thought was, and I think I'm going to stick with this, is that I like the idea of maybe each side of the castle having its own little orchard and having it be very specific to a type of tree, or two types of trees. You know, like, say, for example, the south side would be all birch or something like that. Or a row of birch along the path, and then an outside row of oak or something like that.
That will work.
It'll look cool.
Yeah, I've seen your other one. I liked it.
Yeah.
Okay, coming back. I have a portal that's lit, but I haven't gone through it because I want to build the other one on the other side where I want it.
I see what you're saying. You build the portal in the normal world, and then you go into the nether, build the portal that kind of towards that direction, and it links it to the nearest one that's built in the real world, correct?
Yep. But once you go through it, it'll build a portal in the nether where it thinks it can find space instead of, you know, digging out where you want it.
Yeah, so you got to do it the other way around.
Yeah, you can do it in the nether first. You just don't go through the portal. That's the key. You build them both, light them both, and then when you go through, they should be linked up.
Ah.
But you can't have them too close together, otherwise they might link to the wrong one.
Yeah, yeah, I've done that before. Actually, I've done that more often than I've done it the appropriate way.
Oh, I did that once, but then again I had... Well, you saw the hallway in the other world. I built one of them a little too close, and it linked up to the wrong one. It went one way correctly, but when you went back through, it took you somewhere else. So, that wasn't... All I had to do was move it a couple blocks, and I was good. Come on, horsey! Yahoo!
Yeah, I guess, from what I understand it, the skeleton horses are ever so slightly faster than regular horses, meaning that they're actually the best horse to have as far as, like, traveling.
Well, I would have taken a skeleton, but this is a long trip, and those bones get hard on your butt. So I wanted the padding of the real horse.
You took your first horse then, huh?
Yeah. Well, I took the brown horse. I can't remember who had... I think you had the white one. I had the brown one.
Yep, I took the white one. You took the brown one.
Okay.
Probably says a lot about our personalities right there.
Yeah, you like the white horse and I like the brown horse?
Uh-huh.
Do-do-do-do. Well, once I build the other portal in Nether, which I'll probably do the next stream, I might dig out to it, because it'll still be a trip. But once I do that, we won't have to take this long way anymore. We'll take
a
boat.
What about the horses?
Oh, we're still going to have the horses. We'll ride around. It's just they won't be underground. Well,
you know what we... We ought to make, like, a track for the horses.
Yeah, then we could race. We could do random fence post popping up. Make it a, you know, you never know when you're gonna have to jump.
Yeah, we could do like the steeplechase style racetrack for horses. Mm-hmm. That'd be fun. It's not a bad idea, especially if we did it all like half slabs and well lit, so we didn't have any mob troubles. Mm-hmm. Just a heads up, if you're coming back to the castle, it's creeper time. So there's a bunch of them out front. I'm sure you'll be coming up on the inside.
But definitely, yeah. I'm safe zone.
Just a fair warning, because there are a bunch. There were enough that I was building during the night and decided I probably better run. And I'm glad I did when I did.
Well, if you were going to dig out, it'd be okay. They'd help you dig out.
But actually,
probably ruin your terraforming.
Well, I needed more dirt, so I'm digging the inside deeper while building up the top and the outside.
That seems counterproductive.
Well, you know, as long as you got a path out, it's fine. That's my best way to get dirt, because, I mean, I'm standing on it, so why not?
Oh, yeah, dig some, put some, dig some, put some, I guess. Hey, what do you know? That wasn't too bad.
So many mobs. It's a 3.38 difficulty, but the mobs are out. You'll notice when you come back by the just a sheer amount of experience laying out in front of the building.
Horses do not like to go upstairs.
No. I made an Enderman angry. I'm in the fountain. They don't like water, so you get in water in there. I'm going to chop off your legs while I'm underwater. It's my shinobi strategy. Ha-ha! So, to explain to Carrie here, the Endermen attack you when you look at them. So they get all angry and they charge you, but they can teleport around. And so they'll, like, you go to attack them and they'll teleport behind you and hit you from behind. So they're kind of a frustrating enemy. You just, for the most part, avoid them, but you also need an item that they drop, which that one didn't. Sometimes they drop a very, very useful item that you need to get to the final boss, or what is considered the final. I keep trying to get Carrie into this game, and maybe I can convince her to join the live stream.
Tag, you're right.
Ah!
Hey, you got a little baby following you.
Yeah, I've got to kill the child zombie and try not to feel bad about that.
I was wondering if I could sneak up on you.
Yeah, you did. Well, you know, it's kind of like actually made me jump a little because we've had so many issues with invisible textured enemies in the game.
Uh-huh.
So I was just like, no, not another one of those.
That's why I said tag, so you would know it's just me. I hit you with a torch. Well,
if you meant to say tag the very second that you slapped me in the game, then I can verify that Discord has almost no latency because I heard it at almost the exact same moment that it occurred.
Well, I said tag as I hit you. So
cool. Well, there we go. Yeah, but look at all this experience laying out front. It's ridiculous.
I had to dump off almost a full inventory of sand. I'll come look now. Well, she can certainly join. She is welcome.
We can give her a full set of armor and a bow and say, here, snipe them.
Yeah. Well, you've been busy.
Aw, he despawned. Well, you know, most of this was the ones that were following me as I was running home after digging out some dirt.
Well, I don't see anybody now.
I've thinned the herd quite a bit, I think. Oops. Ah!
I really get faster. Oh, there's two more.
I'm not sure. Was that you?
Yeah. You're overshooting them for some reason.
Yeah.
You got that one.
Oh.
I don't know if I can hit the spider, he's so far away.
Oh, I'm not sure who got that one.
He had two coming. He was those.
Yeah, I gotta say, I really appreciate this construction here, primarily for this.
Mm-hmm. Well, I figured we would have, you know, this for sniping or whatever. And then there's also up top, you can get on top of the, you know, big thing if you want to get another view.
Yeah, I do that sometimes because you get a little bit of a higher perspective on it, which is nice.
Yeah. Put some skeletons over here.
Well, you know, and I did have this all lit up out here so we didn't have mob spawns, but the idea, of course, was to clear out all of the light and let things spawn. And I'm so glad we did, because it's turned it into this whole, like, shooting gallery thing.
Yeah. Well, also, oh, geez. Yeah, you're going to be busy for a while.
Oh, yeah. You've seen my project now, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I'm framing it so, you know, we can both kind of see the area, but in fact, I'd like it to go considerably further to the south and to the east, but, you know, I'm going to concede that realistically this is probably a big enough project for the time being.
Yeah, for now. Gives you something to do in the future. We got to have...
Something to do in the morning, I'll say. I mean... I could just mine nonstop offline, and that way you don't have to be bored as a viewer watching me just mine.
I feel like this episode with me, it was mostly digging and digging and digging.
Yeah, sometimes that happens.
But I needed a glass so I can build the item elevator, and people will like that.
Are you going to do it like the one you had in the other map we were playing on, where you could see the item just drift up ever so slowly?
Yep.
That's awesome.
Well, they did fix it so you can put just a piston and push it up into glass and it will work. The problem is if you have too many items going up at once, it can kind of push them out. And instead of building a mechanism to deal with that, I'll just build what I had in the other seed, which works, because it moderates what goes in there. It's timed, so you don't get too many.
So it's got like a gate that times it out so it doesn't flood it.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So it deals with all the issues, and it's kind of cool to watch it. So... I can show you the other one. I can build one real quick.
Yeah, why not?
I'll go get some resources. Give the viewers a preview, only this one will be a little simpler. Let's see, we will need a piston. Melting. I don't think I have a lever, so I'll have to build one of those. Or a button, I can use a button.
Yeah, You know, what's particularly dangerous about making these little, like, subterranean areas and terraforming by making hollow spaces like this is that if a creeper does blow you up, you know, the explosion might not kill you, but you're definitely dropping into a dungeon full of other mobs.
Yeah. That is definitely the truth. And so you're going to just have to start fighting right away.
Yep, you're just going to have to get ready to run and shoot a bow.
I got cobblestone. I'll make a button.
Pull out a shovel, run for a wall, and start digging or something.
Yeah. Well, when I had all the empty space under here, I fell through a few times, and it's like a fight right off the bat.
But I kind of like it. It literally makes a sort of dungeon feel to it. It would almost be fun to create a sort of cobblestone dungeon with just a single layer dirt roof on it so that if you fall into it, you know, like you drop like 40-some blocks or something. So if the fall doesn't kill you, you then get swarmed by monsters. I mean, it would be good for comedy, but it would suck if it happened to you. I mean, you'd die if you didn't have the right kind of armor, you know, if you made it that deep. I guess you could make it, like, you know, 12 blocks deep so you take fall damage, but it doesn't kill you.
And we both know who we're talking about here, right?
Oh, no, I know.
The comedy value would be me falling into this stupid thing.
Well, sure. And you gotta, I guess you're living up to the name when you do it, but.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I don't know. I like the idea because it is funny where, you know, if a creeper gets you normally without any armor on, it's usually pretty devastating. But once you've got, like, leveled up to this degree, creepers don't seem quite as bad. So this kind of, like, adds that danger back to creepers at this point. You really don't want a creeper to blow up near you because you're not sure if the ground you're standing on is literally one block deep or not. Of course, you know, I could just as easily light the entire subterranean space so that when you go to wire it, you're not having to deal with a crazy amount of mobs jumping out at you every time you want to do something.
Well, I can honestly say that I will light it myself if it's not lit. So. Okay, so there's that. We'll do.
So much to cover.
Okay.
And that's not even really into how I want to round this corner. So sharp and weird.
I'm going to cover that. I'm going to put my rubber there. So I built it.
Where are you at?
I am inside. You'll see me.
I love that mechanism. Oh, there it is.
So basically, I'm going to throw some torches in there. Okay?
Okay.
And what I got is solid glass from this level, eye level, on up. I have one open spot here. And then there's a glass block there, and I have a piston that's going to push the items into the glass.
And when it pushes them into the glass, because it's solid, it launches it to the top of the glass.
Yeah.
Where it detects that it's no longer solid.
Right. So it'll go up, and if you have hoppers up there, it'll go into the hoppers. Now, one thing about this is it's kind of cool. If you watch the top, go ahead and go up to the top, but don't catch the items. This is, I believe, will launch them into the air. I'll put a few more torches in there. Actually, it launched them. Where did it go?
It launched them diagonally.
Yeah, they went out and then just kind of shot off this way. So we're going to have a bunch of torches sitting somewhere.
Huh. Weird.
But yeah, this one launches them, so you kind of have to put a roof on it.
That's weird.
But all you really got to do then is... I don't know where those items are going. I'm going to put a roof on this real quick.
Well, the dirt just landed right here next to the water. That wasn't too bad.
Yeah, I don't know where the torches went.
Yeah, they look like they really flunked.
Let's see. We'll do this. Okay, so then we'll just kind of do this, and they should not launch anymore. We'll throw a little cobblestone in there. Oh, well, they still launched.
Okay, that one went into the pool over here. Oh, there's your torches.
There's my torches. Okay. So, yeah, that... They did make it so that this worked. In 1.9 or 8, this one didn't work anymore. So you had to come up with this that other design, and that other design is pretty cool, and it still works. It's just you gotta block them in so they can't shoot off. I'm not sure why these are shooting off to the left, though. We shouldn't be able to, but whatever.
That's anyway, weird.
That's the item elevator.
Now, maybe the room just needs to be a little bigger at the top or something.
Yeah, I'll figure it out when I build the real one.
What's the primary usefulness for that going to be for you, like in how you're building? How does it come into play?
It's going to bring items from the slime farms up into the system. And I'm going to put another... some way to get them from the farms, the wheat farm and whatever. Basically get items up. Because moving items up you can't do with hoppers. It can only go down or sideways.
Oh, I see.
So you need something to move them up. Now what I've done before is there's a dropper system and it would work, but this one's cooler. So...
It appears to be very quick and effective as well. Like, if you had to move a long distance, it looks like it would be pretty fast.
Yep. Now, I don't think the other one will move this fast. I think this one is just super fast for some reason. But we'll see. It wasn't in the other seat. The other one, it was just a nice, sedate little bring the items up. This one is more of a shoot them out as fast as you can.
Yeah, it really launches them.
Of course, if you're doing a TNT cannon, it's an interesting idea. Okay, did I fix your floor? Looks like it. Okay.
Just built that new one. As I turn around and look at it, there's a zombie chasing me down it. Glad to see it's being used, zombie. That's part of the reason I'm building this stuff right here, though, is and making this a big flat plane is because I want this whole thing not to be lit and to spawn.
Well, it's definitely not lit. And we're protected from them in here anyway, so.
Yeah, it's amazing how open this feels, and yet it's pretty safe in here. I haven't seen a mob spawn inside here since you finished the wall.
Well, there was some at the beginning. I put some more torches off on the, I don't know, whatever side it is to the my right. Chicken farm side.
West.
West. But I haven't seen anything since that inside, so I think I finally got that done. Oh, take that back. There's one up on the village trader system, just fell down. Right here.
Huh. Just as we were speaking of it.
Well, I think I'm going to call it quits for today.
Cool.
I think that people just can't handle any more excitement. It's been too exciting of an episode.
It's pretty fantastic.
So, okay. So anyway, see you next week. Next week I will probably put up the portal that takes us to the desert. I'll probably put the boat path to it because it's still going to be a distance. It'll just be 8 times shorter. And the boats go quicker than a horse anyway, so it should get us there quicker. And then after that, I'm not sure what I'll do. But I'll think on it all week. So I will see you next week, and so will Mindless Machines.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.